Hello and welcome to the Pirates and Raiders Unit Spotlight. Today we'll be introducing the new units available to those who own the Pirates and Raiders Culture Pack, as well as those included in the new free faction of the Getae. First up are the Ardii. These seafaring people hail from the Adriatic coast and were notorious pirates. Known to the Greeks and Romans as the Illyrians, they warred with each other when not fighting their Greek and Macedonian neighbours, and were the scourge of the Adriatic trade lanes. The Ardii have three new units. Illyrian Noble Hoplites are an elite defensive unit with a high armour value. These Hoplites will stand firm against any unit thrown at them. They also have the Encourage trait, so keep them close to other weaker units in your army to keep morale high. Illyrian Raiders are an inexpensive axe-wielding stealth unit, which makes them great at swift, surprise charges into the enemy flank. Their Use the Whip ability gives them a good boost to melee attack and weapon damage. Illyrian Marines are available as both land and naval units, and are good all-round spear infantry. Get them on a swift charge with rapid advance into enemy cavalry, or place them in square formation and use them as a defensive brick to blunt enemy attacks. The Drisian Kingdom were a tribe hailing north of the Greek city-states. As a Thracian people, they were seen as a war-loving, rebellious, and altogether rambunctious bunch. They have one new unit available to them, the Thracian Horsemen. These are ideal at flanking charges and chasing down fleeing foes, and their frenzied charge ability increases their effectiveness and damage as they smash into the enemy at pace. Lastly for Pirates and Raiders is the Celtic Thracian faction of Tillis. This faction has three new units available: Gallo-Thracian Infantry, Raiding Horsemen, and Tribal Warriors. Tribal Warriors are a tough, heavily armoured longsword infantry unit. The longsword was a weapon of high worth and status in the Celtic community, and these veteran swordsmen would earn their blades through many acts of heroism and battlefield prowess. Boasting good defence and attack stats, these warriors will give as good as they get in any engagement. Described by the Greeks as the noblest as well as the most just of all the Thracian tribes, the Getae are the latest free faction to be added to Rome 2. Rather fittingly then, Noble Swords are the new elite unit available to the Getae. These warriors have incredibly high melee attack and weapon damage ratings, making them a formidable heavy sword unit. As with all elite units, they come with the Encourage trait. However, they also have the Headhunt and Frenzy abilities, increasing melee attack and weapon damage, as well as improving base morale to its highest value. This unit will deal out tremendous damage, fight to the last man, and if used well, be near impossible to break. Supporting the heavy infantry base of the Getae are two new ranged units, Dacian Heavy Bowmen and Dacian Heavy Skirmishers. Both are improved successors to the original Bowmen and Skirmishers, and considerably better equipped for melee. Dacian Heavy Skirmishers boast a weapon damage which is enough to rival most light infantry units. With increased armour and melee attack, make sure these units use all their ammunition, then get them into combat. So that's it for this unit spotlight. We hope you enjoy using these new units on the battlefields of Rome 2.
That didn't greet the dirt with open arms, we sent to serve Neptune.